नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण. एनलाइटनिंग टेक्स्ट 44, टेक्स्ट 45 एंड टेक्स्ट 46 ऑफ चैप्टर 9 आंसर्स बाय स्टडिंग द लॉर्ड्स वर्जन ऑफ सेकंड कैंटो द कॉस्मिक मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम. टेक्स्ट 44, तस्मा इदं भागवतम पुराणं दशलक्षणं प्रोक्तं भगवता प्राह प्रीतः पुत्राय भूतकृतो. देयर अपॉन द सप्लीमेंटरी वैदिक लिटरेचर श्रीमद् भागवतम विच वॉज डिस्क्राइब बाय द पर्सनलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड एंड विच कंटेन्स 10 characteristics was told with satisfaction by the father Brahma to his son Narad. Although the Srimad Bhagavatam was spoken in 4 verses, it had 10 characteristics which will be explained in the next chapter. In the 4 verses, it is first said that the Lord existed before the creation, and thus the beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam includes the Vedanta aphorism Janmadi Asya. Janmadi Asya is the beginning, yet the 4 verses in which it is said that the Lord is the root of everything that be, beginning from the creation up to the Supreme Award of the Lord naturally explain the 10 characteristics. One should not misunderstand by wrong interpretation that the Lord spoke only 4 verses and that therefore all the rest of the 17,994 verses are useless. The 10 characteristics, as will be explained in the next chapter, require so many verses just to explain them properly. Brahmaji has also advised Narad previously that he should expand the idea he had heard from Brahmaji. Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructed this to Srila Rupa Goswami in a nutshell, but the disciple Rupa Goswami expanded this very elaborately, and the same subject was further expanded by Jiva Goswami and even further by Shri Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. We are just trying to follow in the footsteps of all these authorities. So Srimad Bhagavatam is not like ordinary fiction or mundane literature. It is unlimited in strength, and however one may expand it according to one's own ability, Bhagavatam still cannot be finished by such expansion. Srimad Bhagavatam, being the sound representation of the Lord, is simultaneously explained in 4 verses and in 4 billion verses, all the same, in as much as the Lord is smaller than the atom and bigger than the unlimited sky. Such is the potency of Srimad Bhagavatam. Text 45. Naradaho praha munaye sarasvatya statendrupo ध्यायते ब्रह्म परमम व्यासा यामित तेजसे. ओ किंग, इन सक्सेशन द ग्रेट सेज नारद इंस्ट्रक्टेड श्रीमद् भागवतम अनटू द अनलिमिटेडली पावरफुल व्यासदेव हु मेडिटेटेड इन डिवोशनल सर्विस अनटू द सुप्रीम पर्सनलिटी ऑफ गॉड एट द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रुथ ऑन द बैंक ऑफ द रिवर सरस्वती. इन द फिफ्थ चैप्टर ऑफ द फर्स्ट कैंटो ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम नारद इंस्ट्रक्टेड द ग्रेट सेज व्यासदेव एज फॉलोज. अथो महाभाग भवान अमोघ दृक शुचि श्रवा सत्यरतो धृतव्रता उरुक्रम स्याखिल बंध मुक्तये समाधि नानु स्मर तद विचे स्थितम. ओ ग्रेटली फॉर्चुनेट पायस फिलोसोफर, योर नेम एंड फेम आर यूनिवर्सल एंड यू आर फिक्स्ड इन द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रुथ विथ स्पॉटलेस कैरेक्टर एंड इनफॉलिबल विजन. आई आस्क यू टू मेडिटेट अपॉन द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द पर्सनलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड हूज एक्टिविटीज आर अनपैरेलल्ड. So in the disciplic succession of the Brahma Sampradaya, the practice of yoga meditation is not neglected. But because the devotees are bhakti yogis, they do not undertake the trouble to meditate upon the impersonal Brahma as indicated here. They meditate on Brahma Paramama or the Supreme Brahma. Brahma realization begins from the impersonal effulgence, but by further progress of such meditation, manifestation of the Supreme Soul, Paramatma realization takes place. And progressive further realization of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is fixed. Shri Narad Muni, as the spiritual master of Vyasdev, knew very well the position of Vyasdev, and thus he certified the qualities of Srila Vyasdev as he was fixed in the absolute truth with great vow, etc. Narad advised meditation upon the transcendental activities of the Lord. Impersonal Brahma has no activities, but the personality of Godhead has many activities, and all such transcendental activities without any tinge of material quality. In the activities of the Supreme Brahma were material activities, then Narad would not have advised Vyasdev to meditate upon them. And the Param Brahma is Lord Shri Krishna, as confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. In the 10th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, when Arjun realized the factual position of Lord Krishna, he addressed Lord Krishna in the following words. Param Brahma Param Dham Pavitram Paramam Bhavan Purusham Shashvatam Divyam Adi Devam Ajam Vibhum Ahusatvam Rushayah Sarve देव ऋषिर नारदस तथा असितो देवलो व्यासः स्वयं चैव प्रविशि मे. अर्जुन समराइज द पर्पस ऑफ द भगवद गीता बाय हिज रियलाइजेशन ऑफ लॉर्ड श्री कृष्ण एंड दस सेड, माय डियर पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड, यू आर द सुप्रीम एब्सोल्यूट ट्रुथ, द ओरिजिनल पर्सन इन द इटर्नल फॉर्म ऑफ ब्लिस एंड नॉलेज, एंड दिस इज कन्फर्म्ड बाय नारद असित देवल एंड व्यास देव, एंड अबव ऑल योर पर्सनल सेल्फ हैज ऑल्सो कन्फर्म्ड इट. भगवद गीता 10.12.13. व्हेन व्यास देव फिक्स्ड हिज माइंड इन मेडिटेशन, ही डिड इट इन भक्ति योग ट्रांस एंड एक्चुअली सॉ द सुप्रीम पर्सन विथ माया द इल्यूजरी एनर्जी इन कॉन्ट्रापोजिशन. एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड बिफोर, द लॉर्ड्स माया or illusion is also a representation because Maya has no existence without the Lord. Darkness is not independent of light. Without light, no one can experience the contraposition of darkness. However, this Maya or illusion cannot overcome the Supreme Personality of Godhead but stands apart from Him, apashrayam. Therefore, perfection of meditation is realization of the Personality of Godhead along with His transcendental activities. Meditation on the impersonal Brahma is a troublesome business for the meditator as confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita 12.5, Klesho Adhika Taras तेषाम अव्यक्ता सप्त चेतसाम. टेक्स्ट 46. यदुताहम त्वया पृष्टो वैराजात् पुरुषादिदं यथासित तदु पाख्यास्ते प्रश्नान् न्यामशच कृतस्नशः. ओ किंग, योर क्वेश्चंस एज टू हाउ द यूनिवर्स बिकेम मैनिफेस्टेड फ्रॉम द जाइगेंटिक फॉर्म ऑफ द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड एज वेल एज अदर क्वेश्चंस आई शैल आंसर इन डिटेल बाय एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द फोर वर्सेस ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड. As stated in the beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam, this great transcendental literature is the ripened fruit of the tree of Vedic knowledge, and therefore all questions that can be humanly possible regarding the universal affairs beginning from its creation are all answered in the Srimad Bhagavatam. The answers depend only on the qualification of the person who explains them. The 10 divisions of Srimad Bhagavatam as explained by the great speaker Srila Shukdeva Goswami are the liberation of all questions, and intelligent persons will derive all intellectual benefits from them by proper utilization. Thus end the Bhakti Vedanta purports of the second canto, 9th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam entitled Answers by citing the Lord's version. Hare Krishna.